Armenians in Sweden. Sweden, officially the Kingdom of Sweden, is a Nordic country on the Scandinavian peninsula in northern Europe. Sweden has land borders with Norway to the west and Finland to the northeast, and it is connected to Denmark by the Øresund Bridge in the south. At 450,295 km², Sweden is the third largest country in the European Union in terms of area, and it has a total population of about 9.2 million. Sweden's capital is Stockholm, which is also the largest city in the country, population of 1.3 million in the urban area and with 2 million in the metropolitan area. The second and third largest cities are Gothenburg and Malmö. Sweden is a constitutional monarchy. Armenians in Sweden. Swedish Armenians are Armenians living in Sweden. The number of Armenians is around 8,000 and they come mainly from countries in the Middle East. Recently, Sweden is seeing some influx from the Republic of Armenia as well. Most Swedish Armenians live in Stockholm, with a significant number in Uppsala. According to the Swedish legend dating from the 10th century, a navigator by the name of Petrus was so enchanted by the beauty of an Armenian princess that he traveled to Armenia and married her. Traces of the Armenian influence are seen in many Swedish literary works and research documents, especially in the Middle Ages. Official Armenian presence in Sweden starts with the 18th century. A group of Armenians from Turkey accompanied Swedish King Carl XII to Sweden in 1714 and stayed on and integrated into the Swedish society over the years. Later on, many Armenians were employed by the Swedish embassy in the Ottoman Turkey. Among those were Hakan Çamlıoğlu, Çamlıcan, who served in the Swedish embassy in Constantinople in the early 1700s, and Hüdayi Ansar Ercan, who held a key position as interpreter at the same embassy in the mid-1700s. Over the years, the Ercan family became closely associated with Swedish diplomatic life in the Ottoman Empire. The senior Ercan's son and grandson, Ignatius Ercan and Abraham Konstantinsson, are well known by Swedish historians. Another Armenian, Abraham Konstantin, served in the Swedish diplomatic corps and at various times was posted in Spain, Holland and Germany. He died in Berlin in 1851. Abraham completed his education at Uppsala University in Sweden, studying Swedish literature, history, mythology and culture. He worked closely with famous Swedish scientist John Berzelius and became an honorary member of the Scientific Union of Uppsala in recognition of his research in chemistry. Jean Anastasi, an Armenian merchant from Damascus, served as Swedish consul general in Egypt from 1828 to 1857. Paul Servino Sedlatian held a similarly important post at the Swedish embassy in Constantinople. The trend continued over many decades. Bohan Demirjian, the son of Stepan Bey Demirjian, who served as the foreign minister of Egypt from 1844 to 1853 and was instrumental in the opening of the Suez Canal, established close ties with the Swedish royal family. Demirjian, who settled in Sweden and was granted citizenship in 1867, is well known in Swedish academic circles as the author of two books on the commercial relations and contacts between European countries of the era and the Orient. Demirjian also built a small chapel on the outskirts of Stockholm. The building still stands and artful texts familiar with Armenian church structures say its interior style, especially its arches and altar-like section, are very close to that seen in Armenian churches worldwide. Communities. Originally, most Armenians came in the later half of the 20th century from countries like Lebanon, Syria and Iran. They were joined later on by a good number of Armenians from Iraq, following the same path as significant numbers of Iraqi Kurds, Assyrians, Chaldeans and Syriacs who had chosen Sweden to escape political turmoil in Iraq to settle in the country. There is also a wave of Armenian immigrants from Armenia and Russia. Armenians have set up their own traditional organizations, also forming the board of the Union of Armenian Associations in Sweden. Homeland also operates in Sweden as a scout union and is active in sports as well. also does the Armenian Relief Society Home of Sweden based in Stockholm. There is also some Armenians living in Malmo, and they have started a club named Club Ararat, which is open on weekends for all people with any kind of Armenian bound. Ararat. ARK Sweden the club. Ararat Armenian Sports was founded on March 30, 1994. Since 1988 we had a football team that took part in different series and cups, but since we did not have any official club we had to play for other Armenian associations in Uppsala. Having a registered club we were able to play with our own name. During the past years we have been participating in several series and cups, among other Korpens series and cup, Uplands series divided 7, the Dios Cup, the Lucia Cup, the Gatrora Cup and the Gutsenda Cup. At the present time we have regular trainings in football boys, seniors and basketball ladies, and hope to expand our activities in other sports as well. Religion. Most Armenians belong to the Armenian Apostolic Church under the jurisdiction of the See of Holy Ekumenism. There is the Armenian Apostolic Church Council and Church in Bakirka, Stockholm. There is also the Arabic Church Youth Affiliate Organization working alongside the church. There is a smaller number belonging to the Armenian Catholic Church, around 150 families. There are church services in Salgurtal and Trollhättan as well.
Ashkarumas imen dunis, bemurvatis murvatsunis. Roshnerit na.